So one of our major campaigns that we do every year, and last year made it much more robust, is our alternative transportation campaign. And so we really studied with our three different audiences, faculty, staff, and students, what their barriers were to leaving single occupancy travel to campus and taking an alternative form of transportation, whether that was taking the bus or walking or riding a bicycle or carpooling. And we tried to find out from them what their barriers were to leaving their single occupancy vehicle car at home, and tried to remove some of those barriers. Some of them were structural, and so we replaced those structural barriers. And I'm going to use the example of people who felt like they couldn't leave their car at home because they might need to do an errand at lunch, or they might need to pick up a child from school, or they might feel like they were going to get left at home, left at work because their carpool needed to leave without them. So different things that we put in place include a portal for finding rides to campus, a ride sharing portal, and that's called Green Ride. And anyone can go onto this portal and plug in information from where they live, what times they like to commute, what kind of music they like to listen to on the radio, for women if they prefer to carpool only with women. And they can find rides who live around them or on their way to work. And another thing that we put in place to help people get past one of those barriers is a Zipcar program. So I myself am a bicycle commuter and I use the Zipcar program. It's a car sharing program, so it's a subscription program, and there are 8 cars placed around campus. And when I need to use a vehicle to go to a meeting in Alachua or, you know, something off campus that's too far for me to bicycle to in the time that I have, I can make a reservation online, and I go and swipe my membership card in front of the car that has been assigned to me. The doors pop open and I get in and the keys are inside, and it's $7 an hour including gas and insurance. So that was, you know, for people who felt like they needed to do an errand or needed a vehicle to get to a meeting or something, we put that in place. For people who said, geez, I just really can't bike around campus to my meetings because I'm too sweaty when I get there, we created a little biker's essential kit, and it's a little drawstring pouch, and it has some face wipes and a little brush and a little deodorant and a little shower cap for your seat in case it's raining like it is today. And it has the One Last Car logo imprinted on it, and One Last Car is the campaign title. And this year for the One Last Car campaign, we put up a online registration portal for people who wanted to pledge to take an alternative mode during the duration of that campaign. And for that, we were trying to create social norms and also to create the idea of making a commitment that was both public and durable. So for that, over 1,600 people registered their pledge to do that and just in the first month that we ran the campaign. And when they made that pledge, they had the opportunity to go in weekly and log their alternative transportation commute miles. And the program calculated for them the amount of carbon they were reducing in taking that alternative mode. So it gave them some feedback. They also got to see everybody else who was registered. We encouraged them to register in teams, again, creating social norms and creating that kind of cohesive social fabric around doing something different, so they didn't feel like they were all out there on their own. And for those who committed to the campaign throughout the duration of the spring, they got a One Last Car t-shirt to wear, and everyone was encouraged to come on the one final hurrah celebration day wearing their One Last Car bright orange t-shirt, so everyone could see, again, social norms, everybody else who was committing and meet and chat, and everyone who wore that t-shirt on that day got a free burrito from Chipotle. We also, during the course of that campaign, offered an alternative transportation fair. And we invited RTS to come and talk about the routes and give feedback, allow people to give feedback on the routes, if the routes were working for them, to see what sort of future plans were. The county came and showed future bicycling plans and bicycle route plans. And we also had different bicycle companies come and help people understand how to fit themselves to a bicycle, where the seat should go, different things about, you know, bicycling safety. We had the University Police Department there with their etching machine, registering bicycles and etching people's names in them. So some of the barriers that was put in place to support, or people, you know, getting over, as people said, geez, I'm 40 years old. I haven't ridden a bicycle since I was 15. I'm nervous about bicycle commuting. So we wanted to help them feel more comfortable and do it in a venue where they had lots of resources available to them and people were friendly and there to make them feel comfortable about asking those questions, so they didn't have to feel like, you know, a person who was really out of it for not knowing how to do that. And people expressed concern, if I bring my bicycle to campus, it's going to get stolen. So we wanted to make sure that they felt comfortable in having their bikes registered and etched and those things. So it probably just seemed like a big party to everyone on the outside, but there was a lot of thought and intention and research that went into every single element of that campaign.